and besties, it's June, which means wedding season. The other day, I attended my first virtual wedding. Oh, this is so beautiful. And I'm still in my PJs. So in honor of wedding season, let's make some miniature wedding stuff. Starting with the cake. We made this cake a long time ago using craft foam, and I love it because we can actually cut it. We're gonna use a similar technique for our cake today. I have white and pink craft foam. I like sticking with a lighter color to make my cakes because I feel like it does a better job of hiding the glue. Take three different types of bottle caps, press them into the foam to make an indention, cut them out to make a circle. Repeat to make mini. I cut 5 pink and 4 white in each size. Stack and glue them every other. I'm using hot glue and I firmly press the 2 layers together to make the cake. When applying the glue, I want good coverage, but I don't want it to be too thick. Otherwise, you'll see like a clear layer between my layers. That's why it's important to move fast and press it down. I've glued all 3. Take a small piece of cardboard, push a pin through it. I did 3. Carefully push the foam onto the pins. Now I'm going to use the hot glue to ice the sides. If you don't want to use hot glue, you can always use puff paint. That's what we used in the past. I'm using hot glue because I think it's going to be faster. Keep them on the pins until they are completely dried. Using my X-Acto knife, I am going to cut a slice out of the smallest cake very carefully. We are cutting through a lot of foam and a lot of glue here, so yeah, be extra careful. The foam gives us a lot of texture, so it kind of looks like cake. And if you want more, you just use an X-Acto knife and kind of rough it up a little bit. I'm gonna cut a slice out of the middle piece of the cake as well. So I have 2 slices, even though that one came out a little uneven. Glue the layers of the cake together. I'm going to off-center those slices just a little. I'm gonna carve a little more out of the cake. Oh, I'm tearing up my cake, but I have a vision. So hopefully this comes out right. Place the cake and the slices back on the pins. Take acrylic paint and paint the icing on the cake. I am not loving that texture. Sometimes I do too much texture. In this case, I didn't do enough. In order to cover the hot glue, we gotta make this really textured. So I'm going to use my hot glue gun to make little swirls all over the cake. Then paint right over it and allow it to dry. On this side of our cake, we have this lovely little hole we cut out. I'm gonna use glue and glitter to fill the hole. First, very carefully, put the glue just down the middle, then add glitter. Put the excess back into the glitter jar. Add more glue on the sides. This time I'm using a larger glitter. It's kind of like fish food flakes. When working with glitter, we have to be very responsible not to waste any. Add more glue to the edge. And this time I'm using a silvery kind of glitter. It looks almost like quartz. Take gold paint and let's just add a little touch around the edges to make a geode cake. Normally you see these cakes with lots of marbling on the side, but since we have all this texture, I can't really do that. So we're gonna have to just decorate it with a few flowers maybe. Which brings us to craft number 2. Let's make flowers. I'm using some white computer paper and a hole punch. Punch out a bunch of circles. We're gonna use these for the petals. Oops, where'd they go? There we are. Cut a small piece of paper, roll it And this is going to be the center of our flower. Begin gluing the circles around it, overlapping them just a little, and you can start to see it take on a flower shape. Let's add another row of petals to make a fuller flower. When making the flowers, I keep that center part a little long so I can use it as a handle when gluing on the petals. It's been a few hours and we've made quite a few flowers. Hopefully this is enough for our wedding. If we want to add a little color, we can use markers. I take a plastic cap and color the bottom with the markers. I'm using a light green. Add a little water, then use a paintbrush to add the color, giving us a very subtle color. Now, if you want the color to be more vibrant, simply add more marker. Then allow them to dry. Use the hole punch on green cardstock. Glue them around the flowers. Not the right leaf shape for roses, but it's still kind of pretty. Trim off the ends and glue them onto the cake. Take more cardstock, punch holes. This time I'm using a small hole punch. Cut thin strips of cardstock, apply glue onto the strip, then press it into the cutouts, and it kinda sorta looks like eucalyptus. Glue them onto the cake to enhance the decorations. If you're not into this kind of style, we can just turn it around for a more traditional wedding cake. Take an empty spool of thread, remove anything that shouldn't be there, paint it. It may take a few coats. We've got a lot of paint there, so we're gonna just let it dry. While waiting, I cut a rectangle of green cardstock, roll it to make the start of a tube. I left a little bit open on the top and bottom, and I'm just gonna cut thin little strips, leaving the center intact. Continue rolling, then glue the end. Punch or cut out a circle. I chose one with a scalloped edge. Cut a line to the center. Cut a small hole. On our little tube here, we're gonna fan out the strips of paper. Take the circle, place it over that center tube. Then we're going to overlap the ends to make a cone and glue it into place. I glued those strips of paper to the cone as well. Make more flowers and eucalyptus and glue them into the cone. I used my hole punch to make more green circles and we're going to glue those onto the sides. I'm going to add some more eucalyptus. All right, that looks pretty good. I'm going to wrap this area with ribbon. I'm gonna glue that down. Glue down the end. Then I'm gonna take a little bit of the ribbon and make a loop and glue it down. Make a bow, glue it on to make a wedding bouquet that the doll can hold. Oh my goodness! These came out so much better than I thought they were going to. Make a single small rose, then glue a circle onto the back. Use double-sided tape to attach it to a suit for a boutonniere. Our spool is finally dry and it's all gold for the most part. Place the cake on top for an instant cake stand. We need a table. We are doing this on a budget, so I'm gonna use some cardboard scraps and white cotton fabric. My cardboard is brown on one side and white on the other. I want the white side facing up on the top of my table so it doesn't shine through my fabric. Draw two circles. I need one to be slightly smaller than the other. Cut them out. Draw triangles that have a long side at 4 3/4 inches. They're more like triangles with the top cut off. Make at least three of those. Glue them in the center of the larger circle with the straight sides meeting in the center. Glue the smaller circle on top, and now we have the foundation of our table. Take the cotton fabric, measure and cut a large piece so when we flip the table over, the fabric can be glued to the bottom side. But before I do that, let's iron out all those wrinkles. Then place the fabric on top of the table flip it over, and glue it to the bottom, making small gathers, or kind of like pleats, as we go. Trim off the excess fabric. When we flip it over, we have a table. I would like for the bottom of my table to sit just a little flatter. So I cut another circle of cardboard, and I'm just gonna glue that underneath to make it nice and neat. We can't put the doll's legs under this table, but it does have a really nice tablecloth, so we're gonna say it's worth it. And it took like 5 minutes to make. Now we can place our cake on top. Use a hole punch on poster board or cardstock. I made mine square, and I'm just gonna fold over the edges, pinching the corners to make a little paper plate. For our slices of cake, let's stand it up since our plate is so small and add a rose. Add a little glitter to make that perfect slice. I think the slices would look better if they were laying down. Just give me a second while I fix this. I'm just gonna leave a mark. And let's paint the cake yellow, because that pink isn't really working for me. That looks so much better. And this time I'm going to leave the roses off. Cut out circles of paper, cut a line to the center point, then curl it to make a cone. Use glue to secure the end. Cut a circle of cardstock, cut the tip off of the cone, glue it to the circle, paint it to make a paper vase. Add our paper flowers, or just the eucalyptus. I found some flowers, the ones we pulled off of the cake, adding to our table decoration. If we remove the cake, we can use it as a centerpiece. And I made a few skinnier ones for wine glasses. Okay, so this is totally turning into my dream virtual wedding. Time to break out my wedding dress, Ma! But first, let's make a background. Something classic and simple. I took pictures of the boxwoods in front of my house, and we're gonna use these to make a back wall. I cut a 15 by 13 piece of foam board, and you can always sub cardboard for foam board. And I cut a 4 by 15 rectangle for the base. Cover the large piece of foam board with the printable. I'm using a glue stick to attach the paper. I had to piece 3 pages together, but it's just so busy, it does a good job of hiding the lines. Glue it onto the base for the easiest background ever. You could even use a different paper on the back and have 2 options. I really like the simplicity of it, so here is our boxwood wall. Place the table in front, and it's kind of getting lost in the background. We need to do a little more. I have a white fabric here. It's kind of sheer. I cut a long strip. It's probably about 8 inches wide, and we're just gonna drape this down the sides and across the top to make our background. We put the table slightly off to the side, and I think that gives us a nice look. Take leftover fabric from making the tablecloth, cut 2 squares. I also cut a small rectangle of the same mesh material we used for the swag. Place it between the 2 layers. Sew around the edge, leaving an opening so it can be turned inside out. Fill it with fluff, sew the opening closed. I made some circles out of metallic wire to make tiny rings. Pinch the fabric in the center of the pillow and use a needle and thread to secure it. Sew the rings onto the pillow to make a ring pillow. All right, so we have a cake, a background, flowers, table, rings. What are we missing? Oh yeah, I know, the dress. We're going to make an infinity dress using white dance fabric. This has a little bit of a stretch and it doesn't need to be hemmed. Fold the fabric in half, then fold it in half again. So we have a center point, and this is pretty much four layers of material. I'm going to cut a quarter circle that is 9 inches on both sides. Let's make that 9.5. I've got to be very careful doing this. I try to keep my lines pretty neat. Did I just mess up? I might have. I am cutting through all four layers to make my quarter circle. Make a small cut at the top. That was probably too much. To make a large circle with a hole in the center. Cut two long strips of fabric. Mine are 18 by 2 inches. Cut a rectangle. This is about 3 by 5 inches. Fold it in half, then fold it so the sides meet. Use a needle and thread to sew a back stitch along the side. For a back stitch, enter the fabric ahead of your last stitch. Then go back and enter at your last stitch or right before it. Then you just repeat. Go forward. And then go back. Try it on the doll. It should fit very snug around the waist. If it doesn't, just make some adjustments and sew it a little tighter. That's better. Now trim off the excess. Make sure that you can get it off the doll. Don't make it so tight you can't get past the hips. Turn it right side out. Here is the raw edge and here is the folded edge. Take the two long strips of fabric, overlap them, match the ends with the raw edge of the material. I sew a few stay stitches to keep everything in place. I'm trying it on my doll and I think those straps are a little wide. Maybe we should go with 1.25 inches rather than 2 inches. So I'm gonna recut these at 18 inches by 1.25 inches. Then sew them back on using a loose stitch that we can remove easily. Let's take the large circle with the hole in the center. The good side is facing up. So I'm going to put this little tube right in the center and line up the edges. I cut my circle a little too large, so I'm just gonna overlap the pieces in the back and use pins to hold it in place. Sew around the edge of all the layers with a back stitch. I made short back stitches going all the way around. I don't wanna go around twice because I don't wanna lose that give there because we do have to get past those doll hips. Tie and knot the ends and remove any loose strings. To make a long skirt with a wide waistband and two straps hanging down. Place it on the doll, then take the two straps and we can use them to go over the shoulders, cross in the back, cross in the front a few times, pulling it tightly, tie it in the back. Then we can just move it around, make small adjustments to make it smoother, to make a simple wedding dress. The beauty about an infinity dress, because this is a real dress design, is that you can make small changes and get a whole new look. By overlapping the straps, I was able to make them thinner, pull them to the side for an off-the-shoulder top, pull the waistband up, and then just go with one shoulder. You really can have fun playing around with many different looks. I really like this look, so I think this is the dress we're going with. Cut a wide wedge of a sheer or tulle material. I'm just using some leftovers from our swag. It's kind of a weird teardrop shape. It's wide and round on one end, then it gets smaller on the other, and I brought it to a flat line. Unfold a paper clip, bend it to make a headband, take the flat end of the material, and you're just gonna go in and out using a very loose stitch to gather it. Sew it onto the headband to make a simple veil. Wow, this is all so great, but I kind of need a groom. I can't find the perfect doll for my husband's mini-me, So we're just gonna use this guy. I'm dressing him in a Ken suit, not loving that pink cummerbund. So let's glue layers of ribbon over it. Use ribbon to make a matching bow tie. Glue it to the shirt. Add the boutonniere. And now we can renew our vows again as dolls. And I am totally digging the idea of a virtual wedding these days. So all we need is a cell phone, and now our friends and family can attend. So we made a cake, flowers, a table, background, wedding rings on a pillow, a dress that has a lot of different looks, and a veil. 7 wedding crafts for your miniature world. Thank you for joining us for these 7 wedding crafts. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell and follow us on Instagram at MyFroggyStuff and The Frog Vlog. And we will see you next time.